Hi and welcome to a series of videos on using MatCam to produce jewelry models. In this video, I'll show you how to set up your MatCam and Rhino for optimal performance in terms of your milling and production. So, first thing we want to do is go to your Rhino properties and go to Mesh. In mesh, you may want to make sure that your density is set to at least 0.8. Seems to be that kind of an optimal setting. And all of the other options, except for minimum edge length, are set to 0. Minimum edge length can be set to both 1 over 10,000 or 0.0001. Leave refine mesh on and everything else off. What this does is assures a good high quality resolution mesh for your for MatCam software to process and create accurate toolpaths. This is the only option that you will need to set in Rhino for a while, so make sure you set up in a configured in a similar fashion. In MatCam itself, to access its options, you find its toolbar, which may be located somewhere else on your screen. Go to the gear icon, wait for it to load, and you'll see a screen with four tabs. General tab is fairly straightforward. You define your milling machine, number of threads. This should correspond to the number of cores that you have in your CPU. Your machine section will specify various folders that point to your machine, post-processor, and the cutters. And the other options can be left alone. Just make sure the curve location is set to cutter tip and adapt is set to front curve. I believe these are the default options, so they're safe to leave as is. Now, the other options to set are related to cutting settings, but we cannot access them directly. We need to select something, some part of a model or some geometry, so let's just pick something here. And now we can go to our cutter options and see what we can define here. If you pick one of the cutters or create one of your own corresponding to a bit that you have, here you will see a few important options. First, the speed settings. Depending on the machine, some of these will be reflecting in your post-processors while others will not be. But nevertheless, these are very important. Your XY speed is your basically key cutting speed. Assuming that you're cutting regular jeweler's wax, say green or orange and the like, you will want this to be really no more than 350 millimeters. This is kind of the speed that is meant for high quality milling, where you don't get too many cloggings or you don't get tips breaking, that sort of a thing. Anything beyond that, then you potentially might start seeing a slightly rough surface. Anything lower than this, and you're just kind of wasting your time going too slow. Of course, the spindle speed will also impact this, but I found that even with rather powerful spindles going really fast and coolant being on, still the quality is not quite as good as what you get with about top speed, about 350. In my case, I'm using an SCNC Mirror 3, and it does not take its spindle speed from here. It's set on the machine directly, and I suggest using approximately 11 to 12,000 RPM when cutting dry, meaning cutting without any cooling fluid, and you can increase that considerably, maybe up to 15, 16,000 when you're cutting with a coolant. Feed Z is the speed with which you have your plunging movements up and down. I have it set at 100. That's kind of a safety mechanism, so that if you somehow do not specify your boundary boxes correctly, say your wax stocks is a little higher, and the bit comes down into it, you will not break your bit tip. So once again, kind of a safety catch, I recommend setting it at 100. If you're confident you're gonna have it correct every time, you can set it higher, but once again. Probably better off waiting a little bit for that tip to descend rather than replacing it. Tolerance is another important setting. I have it set to about 1 over 100. And the reason for that is that it's a good compromise between accuracy and the speed of calculation. Basically, if you set your tolerance to, say, 0.1, 1/10, your calculations will be faster. You'll spend less time in MATCAM waiting for them to finish, but they might vary a little bit from your model. If you set to something lower, to something like 1 over 1000, you will get greater accuracy, but much slower calculation speed, and really probably not worthwhile, not something you will really see reflected on the wax. If you ever do get strange artifacts on some obscure piece or kind of an odd connection in your model, this is a number to check. You might have to kind of tighten up your tolerance and make sure it's not going off doing something funny. Colors and style define how MATCAM draws the toolpaths in your window, in the Rhino window. This is a personal preference. Although I would recommend setting the rapid movements to something a little bit more obvious. There's something like red, for example. This will help you see the rapid traversals and make sure that they're not colliding with your model. MATCAM does not really do any kind of collision checking, so you have to be on the lookout for that yourself all the time. Finally, on this other tab, cut link distance is another important setting. This defines the length of the interval or the distance where the MATCAM will try to connect one toolpath to another without raising the tool bit significantly. So if you have one toolpath and an next step on a toolpath within this kind of limit, within say less than 0.4 of a millimeter, it will try to raise it just a little bit and connect to it. Whereas if the distance exceeds it, it will do a proper raising above the boundary box and then a movement down to your new toolpath location. You have to play with the setting yourself to find something that works for you. I think the default cut link distance is 1. You may find that this wastes a bit of time with your milling machine raising and lowering the bit a bit too often, more than necessary, but that's, once again, it's a very personal preference. One more thing to take note is that on some controllers, on the mills, 5x or 5-axis simultaneous movements are calculated somewhat incorrectly in terms of speed. So if you're using Mach 3, for example, as your controller, the movement of 5-axis simultaneously is considerably slower than you would imagine it to be. So for the feed XY, I generally tend to increase this number by tenfold what you might expect it to be. So if I want to cut at 300 millimeters a second, then, or a minute rather, I'd set it to about 3000, whereas for kind of your regular non-5-axis simultaneous operations, I'd set it to about 300 to 350. Okay, our next options are on 5-axis tools, assuming that you're using a 5-axis cutting approach. And something to keep in mind, if you're going to be using various C-plane perspectives, as I'll show you in later videos, you want to make sure that you define your direction from active C-plane. What this means is that as you change your C-planes, so for example, as you go from here to here to here to here and so on and so forth, your MATCAM toolbit orientation will likewise correspond to your active C-plane. So if you don't have that setting on, it will always try to come down from the top down. That's not always what you want, so once again, make sure you go to your 5-axis tools and set to from active C-plane. That's quite important. It will be repeated in later videos and you'll see just why that's quite important. That's about it. This about for the options in MathCam, you can configure it pretty easily. And then the next step is really going ahead with model specific things and setting up the model to be correctly positioned and choosing a strategy and so on and so forth. But that will be a topic for next video. Thank you for watching.